Hello, this is Elias Atri, aka Stefano from Team Evagenesis, and we are in the Kingston HyperX repair review. Today I'm gonna cast a ZVP which happened to me in La Ladder. I hope you will enjoy it.
Hello everyone. Now I'm gonna cast a ZVP which happened yesterday between me and Bubbles. I don't really know him. ZVP has changed quite a lot since Wings of Liberty. Now the Zerg can't really do anymore the 12 minutes max roach or mass brood rolls. The metagame is totally different. We see a more and more roach Hydra Vipers or Hydra Swarm Host Overseers and Corruptors. I tend to play more on roach Hydra Vipers because the army is more mobile and I master it more than the Swarm Host. I'm having some troubles with Swarm Host lately. So, in the early game, there's not much to say. It was 15 pool, 15 hatch, 3rd hatchery. The Protoss did an interesting build, which was 1 gate Nexus Cybernetic Core. It is. People don't really like it because you get bad economy, let's say. You get the Cybernetic Core quite late. You don't get plus one because you don't have a forge. And you get the Mothership Core a bit late too. So. And as you saw, he can't really wall his base, or he didn't wall it, so I could easily get inside and scout everything, which is very bad for him. Because when you open one gate, Cybernetic Core, you can get a staggered a bit faster, or a robotic, and you can hide it in your base. And he couldn't do that because I had Zerglings in his. That's a shame. And as I have explained in my build order's casting, I tend to go on 5 queens builds to be able to defend any target aggression, to get a lot of creep in case of Immortal All-In or just for the late game. And against any early gate aggression, I have extra queens, which is always helpful. I saw he had 2 or 3 zealots when I had Zerglings in his space, so I know how I have to do some units before making only drones and taking. I had to make like 10 Zerglings. I think this was a fake from him, because attacking with three zealots is not very wise, because he gave me a lot of time to react. And now I can go. Knowing that I have the Roach Warrior and the 2 Queens and Zerglings, I can go on Devil Village Hover and start my upgrades. I take my gas, because I know I'm safe. There's absolutely no way for him to kill me right now. Or he could have done some DTs, but doesn't look like he was going on that. And I'm gonna counterattack. I think I thought he didn't have plus one, that's why I attacked on these zealots. That was a big mistake from me. I shouldn't have done that. But I still had roaches and killed quite a few units, and I could scout his third base. So at this point, I know there will be no attack from him anytime soon. So I can go back on droning, keeping my injects, taking creep, spreading the creep. And expanding, of course. I did kill quite a lot of zealots. The loss are kind of similar right now, so. And knowing that I'm ahead in economy, it's very good for me. So, I'm expanding, spreading the creep, and I can attack really fast now. I go straight Hydra, I make only drones, some units in case of a warping in my base or a shuttle. And I can take straight away to Infestation Pin at tech 3 because I know like I have a way better economy than him, so if I see any aggression coming I can produce straight away with the amount of hatcheries I have. Right now I have 7 hatcheries almost ready. So I can react really fast to anything coming from him. And you see, the opening I made gave me two extra queens, so the creep spread is quite good. In ZVP, the creep spread is really quite bad because you just go on three queens and you keep injecting, never making any creep tumors. Only against Terran you see a lot of creeps, a lot of creep. So this is really important. And I can poke him and take same time to hive. He had quite a bad warp gate positioning on this game. This is a shame because I can kill the warp gate without him leaving his base, like, and he was blocked in his base, and he puts them again in the same spot, which is rather stupid, let's say. On the build I'm doing, I need to focus on the gas. The minerals is important, but Hydralisk are really gas heavy. So I have three base on mineral saturation and two base only for the gas. And I saw he didn't have any Colossi. I saw the High Templar and the Immortal, so I don't need to make any Viper, because the High Templar can just kill them, and I don't have anything to grab, so it's a bit stupid to spend that much gas on it. So this fight, I have to split my army because there's storms, to avoid them as much as possible and to make him waste them, let's say. The thing is, he didn't have enough melee unit zealots to tank the shots of the Hydralisk while the Archons are doing the damage. That's sad for him. And at this point, the game is basically won. I'm going on my 3-3 upgrades. I know he's only on 3 base, and he can't attack me, I'm on 5 base. I have a very good income, good economy, and a lot of larvas, a lot of hatcheries. So it's almost impossible for him to come back. I just finished this little period to let you enjoy the fights. Hydralisk are pretty fun to play with. When you win a fight, you always please with Hydralisk, because when they attack, they do so much damage, and when they don't die, you are really happy with that. Because this unit is so fragile. Right now, I'm kind of just enjoying the game. I know I have one, so I'm taking my time. StarCraft 2 is for pleasure, too, not a job for me. I hope you understand that. Some storms. Nothing too scary. And right now, I have 65 larva. It's always a pleasure to have such a high number of larva. And yeah, just enjoy the show. It is something we don't see every day. And that was it. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you learned.
In this game, you could see the importance of having the 5 queens early game and creep spreading to be able to get the best position against the early aggression or immortal all-in. I hope you learned a lot. This was the Kingston HyperX Reaper review by Stefano from TB Vengeances. Thank you for watching.